Hello. We're here for another Redneck Tech Tip. Just need to hand sanitize real quick. Anytime you touch your nostrils, you should probably sanitize your hands. Hand sanitation is important in tattooing. Also, I'm going to go ahead and grab myself some gloves. Even though we're not about to tattoo, might as well put on the old glovey gloves. Oh boy. Them's the dickens to get on. Alright, so here's what we got. We're doing a side-by-side comparison of the Cheyenne Hawk pen, which was, for a long time, my favorite tattoo machine. My favorite thing I've ever used in tattooing until very recently was Cheyenne tattoo equipment. I started out on the Cheyenne Thunder probably about 4 years ago. Used that, loved it. Great machine, still no complaints about the Thunder. Little history on these Hawk pens. So I've purchased three of these in about 2 years. Bought one, my old manager wasn't the brightest bulb. Sprayed a little Matticide or something down in there, and I guess he did that every day for a while, and then it got to it. Obviously, that's our fault. Cheyenne still got love for you. And then after that, I had one. I took care of it perfectly myself. I did not spray anything down in there where you shouldn't. And the other day, the motor just died on me between tattoos. I had two tattoos to do that day. I finished about a 5 or 6 hour tattoo, ran it, you know, normal, 8.8 volts off of critical. Then it just stopped working. So it was still under warranty because it was only about 5-6 months old, something like that. They got a 1 year warranty on them. So I sent it off to Germany. That cost me $38. It's going to take them about 3 weeks to get it there. Then from what I've heard, it's going to take me at least a couple months to receive the machine back. So I'm assuming it's going to be a month or two of getting in. They'll work on it. They'll assess the problem and fix it, and then send it back to me, probably 3 weeks on top of that to get the machine back. So because I only have two tattoo machines I like that use the cartridge system right now, I have a bunch of coil machines at my house, but I'm not trying to go back to those. I decided to venture out and get me something else. What I got was the Bishop Maggie. I think I'm saying that right. This is a beautiful machine. Smallest machine I've ever seen in my life. It's about the size of my thumb, see? See the machine? Don't see the machine. Magic. Anyway, I got myself the Cheyenne Click Grip for it because I really like the Cheyenne grips. I've been taping them up the same way for a while. Figure, you know, don't change too much. I've also recently changed from Redemption to Purple Glide. Just, you know, checking some things out, trying some new stuff. You can't progress if you never change. Anyway, this is just my review and side-by-side comparison of the two machines. I love this thing. Stroke adjustment on it. You just crank that back, crank it like this. If you what you do is you tape up the end there, then you put the clip cord sleeve over it, and then you don't have to autoclave this because you covered it, but if you do, they've made the Hawk pen to where all the moving stuff is right there. This guy's just a chunk of aluminum. You can throw that right there in the autoclave. Good as new. You're not going to get this dirty unless you're a psycho. So that I really like about it. This, I've been told the click grips, if you autoclave them too many times, aren't great. But same thing. You can take this click grip off there, and then you can autoclave it. Let's say you have a cartridge bust on you or something. I don't think that's ever happened to me. You get a little bit on your push rod or something. You can take the push rod off, autoclave the push rod, I think. If you can't, I know you can replace it pretty affordable. I don't see any reason why that should happen. So my first experience with it was, I like the Hawk pen because it's easy to cover, smooth, you know, whatever. Run it on 8.8 volts for every tattoo, black and gray color, hard lines, whip shading, 27 mag, 9 mag, 3 liner, running all on 8.8. So then what I did is I matched up the speed when I bought this Maggie thing, and that ended up being 7.7. This little sucker runs. It's running about the same speed from what I can feel, hear, and see as how I like to run my Cheyenne. But the problem I had with it is when you put a clip cord sleeve on here and run it over here, you hear this motorcycle sound. You don't want that while you're tattooing, trying to talk to your client about how pretty they are and stuff, saying, "Ooh, girl, check this out." And then they think a motorcycle's coming down your station. That ain't right. So what I ended up having to do is take a sandwich bag, and I had to cut the sandwich bag and tape it from here to here. Now, aside from that, I have literally zero complaints about this machine. I think this is the best machine in the world. I thought nothing in the world could tattoo better than this. There's not much of a difference, to be honest with you. It's still just a direct drive, rotary, lots of power, low voltage, running great, real quiet. I can't tell many differences. All I can tell you is when I'm using a 17 bug pin Magnum on this sucker, it gets in there. And there is no hesitation on either machine, but I prefer this Bishop Maggie right here. This thing is the bee's knees, guys. You need to get you a Bishop. And the other thing I didn't really like is when I put the click grip on there, it was kind of restricted how much I could adjust my throw. Because the click, it actually, there was a nut on there, right? And it's like that little gold nut. So I took that off. And I don't see no problem with this being like this. I tape this up, tape a bag from here to here, tape the clip cord sleeve up on here. And then I put a piece of the clip cord sleeve that I cut off from here to here to cover all that. Everything's covered, taped all the way up to here. The only thing you can see is that silver. You put a cartridge in there, can't see the silver no more. Runs like a dream. And the thing about it is, it looks kind of crazy when you got tape all over it. So I get a little bit of that black cohesive tape, the vet wrap stuff, make it look beautiful. The other thing is, you don't actually have to cover this. I don't think it would really be that big of a deal, because how often are you touching it? Because you're going like this, you're going, rah, 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 so you cover it here. And then when you adjust it, you can hold it like this. Or you could run your clipboard sleeve to here. It's not like you're touching this guy right here. So you probably don't have to cover it. I'm just a little extra cautious. But I have, like I said, zero complaints aside from crazy sound. Sounds like a motorcycle. You can't tell the girls they're pretty while you're tattooing them. Because it's going, it sounds like you got a motorcycle in your hands. You know when you put that playing card on that bicycle spoke and when you were a kid? Okay, so you got that. Now, the other thing is 8.8 volts on this guy. 7.7 volts on this guy. That's what I'm running. Seems about the same. And again, Nico and Vescovi, you guys killed this. This is amazing. I also really like the cord. It's real flimsy, which is good. I mean, it's solid. It's made quality. It's good stuff. But it's real flexible, so it doesn't get all tangled up on you. So I'm running it on a critical. Either way, I got two power supplies back here, so I can do this. If you guys got any questions, send them to rednecks.net/tattooinginthetrailer. And if you ever need distilled water, go to your local Walmart. They got it. Have a good day.